Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch in the Legend of Heroes series for the PlayStation Portable. I am Amethyst Lunatari. One second. Sounds very loud for me. That's better. We're now entering the Grand Cathedral of Oldos. You can only visit the Grand Cathedral once. Open the eyes of your mind and see everything you can. It has been the rule since this cathedral was built. You must see everything carefully. Alright, let's go see everything carefully. And here we are. You pissed off again or something? Yep, you're in a bad mood. And hungry. I gave you food, I don't think we made use of it. It was an attack food. Maybe it was vicious food. Let me give you another one of these. Since you do like them, and I have a lot of them. Good for critical hits. Hopefully get to use it. You have to get in combat before the rabbit gets hungry again. Alright, I can go through here. Okay. Hi. Have you listened to the sermon of the head oracle? You should listen to the head oracle before going out. No, I have not. I gotta praise you now. I will praise you. Isn't that better? It's not enough that I simply feed you, isn't it? I'm just looking around before we go to our main objective. I'm gonna say the same thing. You should be able to hear him talk in the Grand Cathedral. Go out here. It is most tranquil here. Rattel says, as expected, the Grand Cathedral of Oldos is amazing. It provides the best environment to learn spells, regardless of chapel or camp. It's been a difficult journey, but I'm truly glad I came here. I don't even know how I learn new spells. There doesn't seem to be a mechanic that... I mean, you just know the spells you know and you get more when you level up. Alright, I guess we're gonna go through the main entryway here. I'm just gonna look around first, obviously. We've been over here. Oh, we can also go through like this. Hello? I said hello. Grandma Pieta says, I'm taking care of those staying here for their many days of training. These priests are really hard working. Oh, you found something. I don't need that. No books I can look at? Oracle and Terry says, warmth of fire arouses energy and passion. This sentence conveys the power of the shrine in Agunis. Water becomes a mirror and reflects your mind. It must be referring to the shrine in Dean. Any more to say? Okay. Back to the first one. This must be an allusion to Shifuul. A wind delivers the breath of life and sings a poem of blessing. Forests have the mysterious power of life. What's his name? Oracle Morth. Earth heals the dead and leads them to resurrection. It predicts the restoration of the shrine in Tagura destroyed by Galga. I hope Negar Island will soon return to its original state. I still worry about tripping up with that word. Okay, so... talk to him. Oracle Quail says, normal order is common justice. The books here are very edifying. Indeed. Anything else on this side? Yeah. You an oracle too? No, oh, you're Priest Buena. I am receiving training here to become a great priest. I'll study hard in Oldos and return to my village to serve my people. That's very nice. So the grandma's in here, right? And then we go... What's anything in here? No, not really. What about around here? Oh, we can get around the guards that way. It's very sneaky of us. We've been over here. Boo! Priest, be quiet inside the Grand Cathedral. After I'm yelling boo. Yo-Yo says yes. I guess that means he will. Chris says yes. Okay then. Voices can be heard from the back of the Grand Cathedral. Oh, I forgot to mention, guys, this is the 50th episode. It's going to be an extra long episode, probably over an hour. This is what I like to do with our, you know, quote-unquote anniversary episodes. 50, 100, 150, etc. Of course, I don't think we're going to reach 100 with this, but we'll have this episode to be an extra long one, which is good because it's our last shrine, so it's pretty important time. Head Oracle Rezan says, in other words, a long time ago there was no distinction between the chapel spells and canned spells. They used to be one magic power. However, Ortega, the first great oracle and great sorcerer himself, thought harmony would be lost if there remained one. Everything in this world is balanced by two opposing forces. It was too difficult for Jurio and Chris to understand, Head Oracle continued. Yo-Yo says, hey, what is he talking about? What does it mean? Chinny says, shh, I can't hear the head oracle. But you must tell me. Okay. Sosi says, it's like a dream, listening to the head oracle talk in the Great Cathedral of Oldos. Anero says, it's very virtuous. Don't just stand there. Sit down and listen. Well, I'm sitting down. I'm going to walk right up and talk to him. Hi. What are you doing? It'll be over soon, so please be seated. Yurio says, okay. Chris says, sorry. Well, I'm going to sit down now. If someone could do everything, they would be omnipotent. But there would be nothing to compare him against. There would be no measure to correct errors. If a person with omnipotence became arrogant, he could use his power to disturb the harmony of the world. Ortega was concerned about this possibility and divided all spells into the chapel and canned branches. Like we have darkness and light, the moon and the sun, and man and woman. He applied the law of harmony governing all creatures to spells. This is the beginning of the chapel and can spells. But today, we'll take a deeper look. Anero says, it was a good story. Sosi says, the sermons of the head oracle are very easy to understand. I don't think Jurio and Chris agree. Chenny says, right, it's important to have the correct attitude. You guys are all talking, I mean, is he done? Chris says, did you understand the story, Jurio? Kind of. He's saying that we shouldn't use spells for evil purposes. I think... Yo-Yo says, yeah. Alright, everyone left. Still in a bad mood. Can't seem to cure you of your bad mood. Alright. Well, don't... Oh. Don't need that. Don't embarrass us in front of the head priest, okay? Or whatever his name is. Head oracle. My sermon today may have been a little too difficult for you, but don't worry. Everyone should comprehend it within one's own knowledge. What is more important is to feel it yourself. Alright, so where's the magic mirror? I think now we go upstairs. How is the sermon by the head oracle? Ryoyo says, I didn't understand it much. The head oracle gives very virtuous sermons. You may not understand it now, but you will someday. Please enter. I wonder if the other one has anything to say. Don't need it. The more valuable the advice is, the more difficult it is to comprehend. You may not understand it now, but you will someday. Please enter. Or upstairs. That's a dead end. Or is it? Well, we can walk around. Oh, look at that. More stairs. Interesting. Can't get through there. Oh, who's that? There's someone hiding over there. Hey, you! Nanti says, I feel I'm out of place. It's so grand and magnificent, I feel like I'm in heaven. I'm just a country boy. I'm very nervous. He's visibly anxious. Okay. Not only likes to tell us he's nervous, but show us as well. Priest Elti says, hello. Yurio says, hello. I guess Yurio's nervous too. Chris says, hello. You must be pilgrims. Don't be so nervous. I think it came off of Nanti. He got us in this mood. Look around the Grand Cathedral to your heart's content. We will. Stop finding stimulants. We don't need that. Chris asks, what are these pipes on the wall? Oracle Fault says, oh, these. It's called a pipe organ. It produces beautiful sounds. I'll play it for you later, so please listen. When do we listen? When is later? Okay, so we've been over here. Our little magical bunny is happy again. Okay. Well, I guess that's it. So now we go up again. There's stairs. We don't need that either. Thanks for trying, though. Oracle Numa? You can find the Shrine of Oldos above. Chris says, we are pilgrims from Ragpig Village in Pholthe. I'm Chris. I'm Jurio. I am Oracle Numa. Thank you for coming all this way. You must have the silver dagger with you. Jurio says, yes, we do. Jurio showed him the silver dagger. Yes, of course. Now, Oracle Fault, the Governor of Truth, will perform the hymn for callers to celebrate your arrival in Oldos. Oh, is he going to play the pipe organ now? Oh, so now it's later. Sounds familiar. It's like the beginning theme when the title appears. Awesome. Chris says, it's a beautiful melody. Right, it's great. Chris says, thank you very much. Oracle Numa says, the hymn for callers is performed to welcome noble guests. It is a perfect song to welcome you. Why? Says Jurio. The great oracle is waiting for you in the shrine. Please proceed upstairs. Was that an answer? Chris says, the great oracle is waiting for us? Excuse me. I can't tell you anything else. Please ask the great oracle yourselves. Well, I never. What if we talk to him again? Is he ready to say? Let's talk to this guy, the pipe organ. Pholthe, I guess, is his name. He's over there right now. Okay, is that anything new to say now that he's played his piece for us? Chris says, thank you for that beautiful performance just now. Pholthe says, did you like it? Those serene, sacred, and solemn melodies soothe your mind, don't they? Many people say they forget all the fatigue from traveling after listening to the sounds of this pipe organ. Okay. Yeah, we'll continue. I just throw a save in here, just in case of anything. We're afraid of heights. Are you? Great Oracle Denkin says, welcome to the Shrine of Heavens. It's the Great Oracle, says Jurio. What should I do? I'm nervous. Jurio, don't be so intimidated. But he has been waiting for us. Why? Why does he need us? We must introduce ourselves properly, says Chris. Yes. Chris says, we are pilgrims from Ragmic Village in Pholthia. I'm Chris.
I'm Jurio.
Welcome. I am Denkin. I was waiting for you. Jurio says, did you know we would be here today? Well, I didn't know it was you. I didn't know who would come, but I knew someone would come today. Now it is clear to me that it is you two. What do you need us for? Chris says. Please tell us what you saw in the mirror in this shrine. The magic mirror shows different things to different people. You should be able to receive the message we need.
Oh.
The message you need? Jurio says, it sounds serious. Chris says, we're just pilgrims. I think there's been some kind of mistake. Even if I tell you there's no mistake, you probably wouldn't understand. Let me explain it to you from the beginning. Please come this way. Coming this way continues. I view the magic mirror in this shrine every day. After all, it's my job to do so. I see the images in the magic mirror and foretell the currents of the time to help the people. Around a half year ago, the magic mirror began showing ominous images. Whirling darkness, Galaga's attack, and a man in black with an eerie aura that swallows stars. This must be a sign of a great calamity that is to come. Jurio says, we saw the same image in the mirrors in the other shrines. The shrines in different places are all connected to the Shrine of Heavens here in Oldos. Since you have visited all the shrines, you can analyze what it is from the images you saw in the magic mirror here and the other four mirrors. Jurio asks, are we the only ones who can give you the answer? That's right. Only those who have been to all shrines can give us the answer. No matter how hard I try, the magic mirror won't tell me enough. Although I know something evil will occur, I am unable to find out anything specific. Chris says, I understand, Great Oracle. We'll tell you what we have seen from the magic mirrors. Yes, then we can tell what will happen and prepare for it. Please view the magic mirror now. Okay. Jurio says, but how did you know we were coming? I received a message through the magic mirror several days ago. It said that someone who traveled the four shrines according to the ancient custom of pilgrimage would arrive in Oldos. Chris, it sounds like we are chosen heroes. You have too much imagination. Heroes and great men are more dashing, unlike you. Oh. Harsh. I was just feeling good about myself. You are not chosen ones, but ones who can receive a message. I can say this, however. You are destined to play an extraordinarily important role. Now I'm getting nervous, Jurio says. Jurio, we should view the magic mirror anyway. Jurio, I guess, thinks. Chris is always enthusiastic in this kind of situation. Let's go, says Chris. Alright, here we go. Place the dagger. Someone getting power from the stars? In that castle. The silver dagger glows dimly as if to resonate with the shine of the shrine in Oldos. Jurio can now summon the thunder spirit Lumiere. It's strange, says Chris. Not only do I see the images, I think I also hear something. Is it a word? I wish I could make it out. I heard something too. It said Ra-U-All. You heard it too, Jurio? Yeah. What does Ryuall mean? I have no idea. By the way, did you see that crest? It was the crest of Pholthe. Okay, so that what was on the banners? That means the castle was Castle Rudo in Pholthe? I have never been to the castle, but I think so. Jurio says, do you think they're going to start a war? I saw lots of soldiers. Chris says, I remember the Pholthe army was drafting soldiers. There was also a suspicious man who looked like a sorcerer. Right. He was letting go of a glowing ball that rose toward the ceiling. Was it inside the castle? What was that? It's no use racking our brains, Chris says. Let's talk to the Great Oracle. Great Oracle Denkin was waiting with a grave expression on his face. Jurio and Chris explained the images they saw in the magic mirror in detail. Oh, I see. Something disturbing is going on in Pholthe. Another thing, says Jurio, we could only see images at the other shrines, but this time we heard sound, too. Sound? Chris says, it said Ryuall. I have no clue what it means, but we heard it. Ryuall? Are you sure? Ryuall. Ryuall. Chris says, is it important? I can't believe this. If the wave of Ryuall has begun to travel, the situation must be very grave. Jurio says, what is the wave of Ryuall? The prophecies say, The wave of Ryual is the wave of destruction which will engulf the entire land and bring about the end of civilization. The wave of destruction? If the wave of Ryual is truly moving, then the end of this world is near. The end of the world? Says Chris. That's absurd, Jurio says. But who? Who called the wave of Ryual? I don't even know if I'm saying that right. No one can summon the wave unless he knows the spells of another world. Which is like capitalized, like proper noun. Not to mention the existence of Ryual is known only to a handful of people in Oldos. Is a sorcerer from another world hiding somewhere in this world? And is Pholthe the trigger of the great tragedy? Maybe something has happened to King Rudolph of Pholthe. Jurio, what are we going to do? Our country, our king, will be the trigger of the destruction of the world. Great Oracle? Jurio says. Yes. We answered the questions given by an oracle at the bridge before entering the Grand Cathedral. When he asked if the magic mirrors only showed the truth, I answered no. The magic mirror in Tagura showed an image of Bolt being destroyed by Galga, but Bolt was actually spared. The oracle said the right answer was no. Yeah, that surprised me too. I think what we see in the magic mirrors are not definite futures, but warnings. Right, Chris says. We saw an image of a forest in Shifool. Jurio says that was not a prophecy either. It was right after that wizard cast a spell on Chris. The forest we saw in that magic mirror was the Forest of Deception, where the Algres live. The magic mirror gave us a clue. Even before Chris fell ill, the mirror told us where we could find an Algres whose horn was necessary to mix a healing potion. I see. I don't think everything the magic mirrors show will come true. They are foretelling that, if nothing is done about them, will come true. So even though we saw the wave of Ryual in the magic mirror, if we take the right action, the world won't be destroyed. Oracle Dinkin says, I haven't heard such a brave statement in a long time. I lost my composure, even at my age, because of the seriousness of the matter. But you're right. That's what the magic mirrors do. Chris, let's go back to Pholthe at once. We must go to Castle Rudo and see what is happening, just like we did during the Galga incident. There was no guarantee we could have done something to help in Bolt. But with a big effort from everyone, we might be able to prevent what we saw in the mirror from happening. Chris says, I think so too. We all worked hard. Alf, Lodi, Ms. Magisa, and Mr. Morrison. You know what, Jurio? What? You must have grown up a little. Really? Jurio says, so we are truly the chosen heroes. Can't you get that idea already out of your head? I told you, heroes and great men are dashing, unlike you. I was just feeling good about myself. Same thing, he says. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Jurio, we must leave for Castle Rudo. Oracle Denkin says, it wasn't a coincidence that you visited Oldos with a mission at this point. I don't think you have the special power that only the chosen ones have, but I certainly feel a ray of hope in you. Go to Castle Rudo, will you? Yes, we will, Jurio says. Thanks to you, I was able to decipher the magic message from the magic mirror. I will start researching. We should be able to help you from here. We'll be counting on you. Chris says, yes, your support will be of great help. Jurio says, I have one question, Great Oracle. What is it? What is the relationship between the magic mirrors in the five shrines and the Moonlight Witch? I heard many rumors about the Moonlight Witch on our way here. The Moonlight Witch. Gweld was a pilgrim, leaving prophecies as she went along. She came to Oldos around 20 years ago, and I met her personally. Gweld left fragments of prophecies, but she didn't say anything about the wave of Ryual. Now I know why. Gweld knew everything. She could see the wave of Ryual appear and threaten to destroy the world unless something was done. But she couldn't tell anyone. The wave of Ryual was just too horrible to burden people with. In fact, there were not many who could use spells those days, and spells were not accepted by people as they are now. Chapel and Cand had just been born, and people were still skeptical and fearful of witches and sorcerers. When witches preached their prophecies on the street, people verbally abused them and often threw stones at them. It was a terrible time. Chris says she preached prophecies for people. Poor Gweld. Denkin says, how could she tell those people that their world was going to be destroyed? Yo-Yo says, what happened to Gweld after that? Is she still alive? Asks Chris. Unfortunately, I don't know. If she was alive, we should be hearing a rumor or two about her. Yo-Yo says, but we were saved by Gweld many times. We stopped Galga's attack and found the Algraz in the Forest of Deception. That all happened because of Gweld's hints. Denkin says, probably Gweld was leaving steps for those who would follow, believing that someday people like you would appear and listen to her. I feel the same, says Chris. Right, Yurio says. Great Oracle, we'll leave for Castle Rudo now. You should find Gweld's messages on your way. Use them as clues, and you'll know what to do. We'll be counting on you. We don't know what happened to Gweld. However, her intentions live on in the magic mirror and the minds of people like yourselves. I felt it strongly after talking with you. Please travel safely. Alright, I don't know if there's anything else to see up here. There's stairs there. Wow. If this was a normal episode, we'd be concluding it right now because we're already a half hour. And all we've done is walk up here and talk to some people and look at the magic mirror. Alright, back down. Don't fall. The Great Oracle said that something will shake the whole world. That will shake the whole world is about to begin. We don't know what it is exactly, even after utilizing all the resources of Oldos to find out. However, the Great Oracle said this morning that someone who understands it would come. My intuition told me the same thing, and he must have been referring to you two. Still nervous? Okay. Alright. Oops. I'm done entering. Now we exit. So how long of a journey is it back to Castle Rudo? It's like back to where we began, isn't it? Your pilgrimage won't be complete until you return home. Apply yourself harder on your way home. Don't tell us what to do. I hope you learned something. Return home safely. No, thank you. Thank you.
Your face is a bit stiff, Choa says. I suggest you not worry about it too much. It may be a grave problem, but think of it as a cleaning. You clean each area one at a time and the entire room will become clean. I thought she was talking about the wave of Raiwal or whatever. Good luck. The grand cleaning of the human race, right? You must have been given an important message. I don't know what you saw, but I can sense the seriousness of it. Listen carefully. Don't just be alarmed by the message. Think of what you should do about it, and then do it. Okay. I love the song. What the magic mirror shows is a message to the person who sees it. However, the message may be wasted if the person doesn't act on it. The important thing isn't to receive a message from the magic mirror, right, but to do something about it. What is most important is to act properly after receiving the message. Chris says, let's go back to the inn and set out immediately. We have no time to waste. Hey, Chris. What? I'm thinking we shouldn't tell Mr. Morrison about this. Mr. Morrison is such a kind person. If he learns about Raiwal, he will insist on coming to Castle Rudo with us instead of going back to Ambush. You're right, says Chris. We can't trouble Mr. Morrison anymore. Alf needs Mr. Morrison in Ambush, too. We should keep it a secret from Mr. Morrison. Okay, then. Well, is Philly going to be coming with us? Okay. Morrison says, how is the cathedral? It was all so grand inside, says Jurio. We saw the magic mirror, too. We also spoke with the Great Oracle. That's good. I had my training at the Grand Cathedral before. I remember it all like it was yesterday. Chris says, Jurio has been sighing nonstop. I don't blame him. Anyway, now I have completed my mission. I will return to Ambush and gladly present my report to His Majesty. Surprised he is not asking what they saw in the mirror. Mr. Morrison, thank you very much, says Chris. Jurio says, tell Alf, King Alfred, we arrived safely in Oldos. I will. Philly says, Jurio, may I travel with you half the way? I'm scared to return home by myself. Please? Of course. We asked you to come to Oldos. We will take you home. Chris says, Jurio is trying to please her. Good. They didn't tell Morrison about the wave of Raiwal. After visiting the Grand Cathedral, Jurio and Chris immediately headed for their homeland, Pholthe. Okay. I must say goodbye here, Morrison says. I'm sad, says Jurio. It was an eventful journey, but it was also pleasant. Please take care of yourselves and return home safely. Chris says thank you. Morrison says, take care. Jurio says, you take care too, Mr. Morrison. Say hello to Ms. Magisa too. I will. Goodbye, Mr. Morrison, says Chris. If Lodi is still in the castle, please kick him out. Yes, I know that. Goodbye. Well, that was a big font there. Philly doesn't care. She doesn't say goodbye to him. Jurio says, he's gone. Yeah. I feel guilty. You shouldn't, says Chris. I think... Shall we go, says Philly? Saying goodbye is always sad. I may cry when I bid farewell to Jurio. Aw. Chris has a question mark. We must go, says Philly. Fading out. What a world, what a world. Kajim's curse now gone, Jurio and Christina lay eyes upon the magic mirror at the final shrine in the Grand Cathedral at Oldos. Yet the implications of what they see in it are dire indeed. The wave of Raiwal is coming. a wave of destruction said to engulf the land when a civilization breathes its last. Jurio and Christina head for Castle Rudo in Pholthe, following the vague clues left by the Moonlight Witch. Chapter 4, The Forest, ends. Now beginning... Chapter 5, A Lake Divided. We gotta run all the way back. Lucky, Ryunel says, we came all the way to Oldos. It's so sad to remain cursed. Does he know about the wave of Ryuol? Are there... Okay. And talk to her and see if there's more... More new stuff here. Nothing new here. I do not need that. Yeah, we all have fleeting robes. Alright. Let's go. Don't need that either. Are we going south then? Yeah, right, halfway. So we're gonna drop Philly off somewhere, yeah, over here. So I guess we're going there first. And then from there. Just trying to look around a little bit. Pholthe all the way up there. Alright. So I guess we're going south-ish to the Torav checkpoint. Jurio says, once we pass this checkpoint, we'll be in Fenty. Thanks for everything. Oh, that's it already? Chris says, Philly, I guess this is where we part. I'll guide you for a little longer. Huh? Why? You're going to Hazen, aren't you? This isn't halfway. We were going to Riz's house on the way. It's a lonely road to Haruku. I'd be worried about you. But how are you going to get back from Haruku? I'll be okay. There's a road that's too rough to show you. It's a shortcut to my house from Haruku. She doesn't want to say goodbye to Jurio. It's a wild path that I use to collect herbs. I can get back by myself, so I'll accompany you to Haruku. If it's okay with Jurio. Not if it's okay with Chris. She don't care about that. I don't mind. How about you, Chris? I guess it's okay. Why are you shouting? Says Jurio. No reason. It's okay. It's better to travel with more friends anyway. Okay, it's decided, says Jurio. I'll accompany you. Too funny. Alright, so we're going to Haruko then. Fenty from here. Be sure to show your papers to the officers. The west room is for Hayes and the east room is for Hiroko. Okay. So where's the east room? Oh, this one? Yo-Yo, show the silver dagger. Oh, the silver dagger. This way leads to Hiroko. Is that where you want to go? Yo-Yo says, yeah, we're heading to Hiroko. Please go ahead. I said, please go ahead. Alright then. I can't see. Thank you. South Louise Checkpoint, 1016 Milos. Alright. Fight monstrous. Wild boar, healer, hermit, and what else? Oh yeah. Cool. Better criticals. Healer, hermit, and rapoople. A and B. Alright, let's do a finishing move on the healer, hermit. Nice. So that's not a regular wild boar, that's another boar. Well, these things hit hard. Jeez. Don't you be hit, my girlfriend. Oh boy, not good. I'll patch you up. She's patching herself up. I'm glad it missed. Finishing move on the B one. This thing's still alive? Good God. Revive Philly, yeah. May thee stand and fight again! Revive! Oh sweet, a little fairy appears. These things are tough, and I didn't save either. Let's use a stimulant. Recure potion does more, right? All healing each other. Crap. Take him downtown. That was tough. Oh, but look at all that XP. Nice, and then Jurio levels up. His bar kept going. I wonder if Chris is going to level up too. Yes, awesome. And we got a cure potion. Wow. Definitely saving. All right, so we're going south to Louise checkpoint. Guys were tough, but they gave a lot of XP. There's only three this time. Let's all go for the healer hermit. Okay, those things hit hard. Let's go for the rat poople. Yay! We'll use our special moves next time. Nice. Spicy food and a cure potion. Speaking of which, are you hungry yet? Bad mood. And hungry. Okay, good. I want to give you some attack stuff this time. Angel food. And I'll praise you as it is. Still in a bad mood? Well, hopefully you get out of that. Jurio says, Chris, how are you feeling? I think I'm okay now. Philly says, Chris, Jurio's a really nice guy, isn't he? Huh? What are you talking about? When you were cursed, Jurio was trying so hard to help you. Really? Even Sherla was impressed. He was so brave. Jurio was just simple-minded, that's all. He was probably worried that I'd beat him up if he didn't. But he's trustworthy sometimes. Haha. Wow. That was interesting. That's anger! Okay. Jurio finishing move on the healer hermit. Chris, I guess, will attack the wild boar. And Philly, finishing move on Rapoople A. Poor thing. Blasted out of existence. And the punishment is death. Philly's gonna level up soon. Cure potion? Could be the next battle. Doesn't Philly know? Yeah, she knows cure as well. Trying to keep us up because these battles are pretty tough. I'm just gonna save over this one. So we can't really go directly south. There's a finishing move on the hermit. At least we're able to finish things off with the finishing move this time. Oh, wait. Nothing. She's not gonna make it there. Come on, Billy! Ah, not yet. We're finding a lot of cure potions. Well, we're full of them, aren't we? Oh no, we only have 6. So you've been using them. I remember using like 1 or 2 of them, that's it. Actually, here. Let's try this out. The Thunder Spirit. Zero. Wow, that's not good. Show yourself, Spirit of Light. Feel my soul. Come to my aid. Lumiere. That's our new one. Good amount of damage. Let's finish this hermit off. Zero again. Oh, it knocked him right off the screen. Okay, we're getting banged around quite a bit. Yes. Banged her right across. Alright, we hit that one. We hit Rapoople A. Let's see if we can paralyze Rapoople B. We'll do Air Tornado as well. Gentle mind, churn and swirl, swallow them all. Air Tornado. Oh, we're getting all of them. Excellent. Awesome, 2 of them gone. Shining chains, be thine bane. Paralyze. See if it works. Oh, cool. Now we finish it off at our leisure, and look, we all have full finishing moves for next battle. Yeah, Philly, let's go! Nice. Don't learn anything new, though, unfortunately. Okay, so Philly's got a lot more magic points right now. Let's cure people up. Oh, what's that thing? Luis checkpoint, and north is a Torov checkpoint, 1016 Milos. Ran all that way. And here we are. Indeed. Normal mood. Not hungry. Okay. Hello there. No other way in, is there? Welcome back. You're at the South Fenty border checkpoint. Yuya says, huh? Are you a Fenty soldier? Yeah. As you can see, it says that when you have the dialogue. But this is the ambush side, isn't it? Should an ambush soldier be guarding this point? Oh, I guess the Fenty army won? Yeah, usually, but it's far from ambush. Hmm. If someone is sent from ambush, they'd have to go all the way around through the three-city bridge and through Udor. Chris says, wow, such a hassle. Yep, that's why they decided that this checkpoint will be manned by South Fenty. Oh, I thought it was like that army won. I see, Fenty and ambush are such good allies. Of course, because we're next to each other. I think countries have to help each other in this day and age. I'm proud to be here guarding this border. Hmm. This seems a little suspicious to me. Hi. Danny the guide says, good work. Be sure to complete all your paperwork in the next room to enter the country. What good work? We'll have to talk to him. Adley says, hello. Hi, says Jurio. Wow, lucky you. You get to travel with two girls. I'm so jelly. Chris says, you mean jealous? No, it means jelly. Jelly. Let's go look around before we talk to him. This is a prison, but there's no one in here now. There aren't that many people who do bad things around here. I hear bandits are around in Northern Fenty, but it's really peaceful here. Oh, him too? You have to talk to both of them? I'm stuck on this guy. Immigration officer says, please, go ahead. Jurio says, we're on our way back from Oldos. Jurio showed the silver dagger. Oh, so on your way back from your pilgrimage? Well, welcome back. Please go through. A party of three, right? Please go on. Chris says, thank you. You're so young, but so dependable. I hope you'll grow up to be good people. We're good people already. Nerve of this guy. Please go through. Please be careful. I guess either one you talk to. Alright. No one else to talk to here? Except this guy? It looks like your paperwork is in order. Please go through. Alright, first we'll, like, hide around the bushes here. Oh, there's nothing over here. Okay. Alright, back to South Heats Road. You wanna read the sign? Luis Checkpoint, East Haruku, 1071 Milos. Hold on, there's a monster. Have at thee, monstre. It's the same kind. Alright, so... finishing move on Healer Hermit. Chris does finishing move on Rapoople A. And then Philly does finishing move on Rapoople B. What's this thing? Shocker Sybil? We'll see that what that does. It does 26 damage. Hopefully they'll all be finished off. Nice. It still lives. No. No paralyze. He missed, haha. Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum. I wanted to hit the Rapoople ball. Alright. Finish this thing off. It's probably just so damaged already. Ugh. Ah, I paralyzed her. At least we finished that off. And that off. Chris levels up. Yay! I didn't realize she was behind the other two. She got a Furuvu potion. Well, we got her Furuvu potion. Alright, so... let's see. I'm gonna... take a potion after this. Oops. Well, we're like healed up already, so, was it mental potion? Mind potion. Use it on Chris. Use it again. And use it on Philly once. That's good. And save. Hi. Same crowd. All right, let's do Thunder Spirit. I don't like this paralyzing stuff. So let's try to take it out. If at all possible. Panic too? Ah. She's just running around like crazy. Curing it. Okay. These are finally some challenging battles here. Not sure how I feel about that. Can't reach her from here. I'm not even sure. Let's see. Oh, we can get information here. Immediately cures a poison character. Cures all negative effects for Ruru Potion. That's what we're gonna use, if we can. Yeah, on Chris. What'd she say? Oh no, it's casting Panic again. On her again! Kill this thing, thank you. At least she hit the enemy, but for no avail. To no avail. Alright, let's use it again for Ruru Potion. Now that thing's not around to panic her and stuff, so we should be good. Oh, there's two of those healer things. Ugh. They're like healing each other. It's no good. He's gonna heal it, isn't he? The other guy. No, no, they're just attacking. Right. Get rid of it! Damn! Maybe they're out of mana. Can we kill this thing? Thank you. Taking a beating over here. Oh, it only hits this guy. That's a good amount of damage. Nice. And we got full attacks for next time. The mind potion good, because we used one. And we'll probably end up using more. We doth fight you. Alright, finishing move on the Chakra Sybil. Finishing move on the Healer Hermit. And finishing move on the Rapupal A. Let's hope at least some of these things get one-shotted to death. Especially this thing. Yay! No status effect problems this time. Now we need to focus on A. It's not a problem, it's right in front. Yay. Don't tell it to forgive you. You see that thing? It's nasty. Let's top Philly off here. Alright, we must be getting close to something. I really hate those things. Nice, we got rid of it, at least. Does it say what the magic does too? Okay. Because I don't think we have... Okay, cure body. Cure body does that. Okay. Cure body on Chris. Sacred light. Cure body. Because we don't have too many of those Furu potions. I think just four left. Alright, we were attacking A. Better to kill the healers first. So they don't heal the others. Like that. Damn. Damn you! Now, Philly doesn't normally do attack on... I mean, damage on it, so... Let's do the air tornado. Trying to get rid of this first one. Nice. Yeah, finishing move on the healer hermit. And then finishing move on the reputable. These things can't be killed by the finishing move alone. At least not the light cactus. Jurio levels? Yay! 24. We're not learning any more skills and stuff, I noticed. I want to learn some more skills. Alright, Chris has got a lot of magic right now. Mind potion on Philly. And again. I guess we'll be calling it an episode soon. I just want to get somewhere. Nice. I approve. Should we dare try to finish off the Rapoople first before these guys can heal them? Him? It? Dead. Doing a lot of damage on him. Alright, we're attacking B. Let's try to paralyze A. Oh, we can't. Alright, let's try to paralyze B. And we'll attack A now. Awesome. Chris might level up next time. I will fight you too. I'm enjoying all the XP we're getting here. We should be able to finish off the finishing move on the Chakra Sybil. I don't know why it's called that. I was just attacking normally. Can't stand those things. Finishing move O-Rama. We seem to be getting our finishing moves quickly, more quicker this time. Like, lately. Maybe that improves with level? I'm not sure. Chris! Yes! Level 23. I'll just attack you and then we'll continue north. No, don't paralyze. Defend! The magic defense! Ah, fail. Good. Body and Chris. No, I was attacking A. Thank you. Good, another Furuya potion and mind potion, because we used both of those recently. Nothing over there. There's another enemy there. Who's got the most magic? Chris. Yeah, I don't want them to be running out. Let's just use a mind potion on Felicia. She's running pretty low. These status effects could really get you stuck, so. Finishing move on the shocker thingy. Finishing move on this guy. I think he's the least damaged. Wow, 632 damage. Nice. Philly, level 24, and has learned power herbs. Wow. And we got spicy food and a mind potion. I wonder if our bunny is hungry yet. Good mood, not hungry yet. Okay. So, what is that? Temporary boost to attack power and defense. Sweet. Oh, and healing herbs is a skill. Oh, she can use that without having to use her magic. Cures negative effects. Now I remember this there. we can use a little bit of healing. Right. Jeez. Let's try to get somewhere. Whoop. Oh, we have to go this way? These battles are really repetitive, so. Heroku, the subcapital of Fenthi. East is the Louise checkpoint, 1071 Milos. Now, does north go anywhere? Because it looked like we can go north. Oh no, there's a lake there. Never mind. Oh, thank you. Full cure potion. That's really helpful. I've yet to use them, but maybe I should use them soon. Because we can't collect anymore. Oh, this is a wall. Never mind. We made it! Philly says, we're here! We made it to Haruku! Soldier says, hey, you! Did you just arrive here in Haruku? Yes, says Jurio. Did you see any other travelers on the road? Chris says, no, we didn't see anyone else. I see. I guess the eastern border has been completely closed. Closed? Says Chris. Oh, it's okay. It doesn't have anything to do with you. If no other travelers are on their way, all we have to do is make sure nobody leaves the town. The eastern entrance can be guarded by one soldier. Okay. Anyway, gonna call it an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Stay tuned for the next one where we explore Haruku. And not pick up a remind potion. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.